around the UK.
Spell it.
Are heading to the Great British Menu Kitchen.
What can go wrong?
We'll find out.
They're in a race.
I need to crack on.
To cook a course at a record-breaking banquet.
The things you do on the Great British Menu.
Woo-hoo-hoo. The ultimate prize in any chef's career.
It's a sprint. 100%.
This year, the banquet is celebrating the Olympics and Paralympics. As Team GB limber up for the 2024 Paris Games.
Move, move, move. Come on.
It will be held in the sumptuous British Ambassador's Residence in the heart of Paris, the home of classical cuisine.
Oh la la. Fire.
Competitors need to come up with dishes that are worthy of such a majestic feast.
So get the mouth watering.
Olympian in their ambition.
Famous last words, eh, man?
And strive for a personal best.
Wow, that looks incredible. Yay!
Because some former champions, veterans of the competition,
ooh, I'm relaxed,
are returning to score them.
Wow.
Michelin-starred winners themselves.
I'm ready for action. Let's go.
And they won't be pulling any punches.
I'm scoring you a 4.
It's a fish course. It's been about 8 years since I last gave a 10.
The dishes need to be worthy of a place on the podium. To impress the demanding lineup of judges.
Beautiful.
They're searching for courage, spirit, and ambition in every dish.
I love it.
On your marks, set, go. It's Great British Menu. Yes.
Let the games commence.
This week, it's up and coming chefs from Northern Ireland.
Wow.
This week, the most promising chefs from Northern Ireland are competing with dishes celebrating the founder of modern-day Olympics and Northern Ireland pentathlon legend, Mary Peters. The first of our four newcomers is Lottie Norrin, originally from the Lake District and now head chef at Edo in Belfast.
Representing Northern Ireland is massive for me. My dad was from Northern Ireland and now I have a beautiful family in Belfast. And I just want to do them proud.
Also from Belfast, Colin McSherry. Having worked in top kitchens in and around London for 20 years, he recently moved back home.
What's at stake for me is my massive ego, I suppose. So, yeah, hopefully I can live up to it. Hello,
Hi,
how are you?
What's happening?
I'm Colin.
You're good.
What I want to achieve is to get a dish to the banquet.
Niall Sarhans from Antrim's first job was his dad's kebab shop. Since then, he's worked in some of Northern Ireland's best restaurants and specialises in seafood.
Now,
Colin. Nice to meet you.
I'm Lottie. Nice to meet you. You're good?
Nervous?
Absolutely.
Yeah. To be in the Great British Menu Kitchen, it's surreal. It's something that you never think it was going to happen, but it is, and can't wait to start cooking my dishes.
Melissa McCabe completes our kitchen cohort. After travelling the world working in top restaurants, Melissa now runs a food truck and sees herself as the underdog.
Yeah, how are you?
Hi.
You excited?
Yes, 50-50, nervous and excited. What makes me different from the other chefs? I have a food truck, I don't have any staff, so maybe that will be to my advantage because I'm by myself here.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
How are you doing, chefs?
Good, how are you?
Nervous? You're nervous, my love.
Just a tad bit.
Ah, Lottie, you're going to be absolutely fine, don't you worry.
I will look after you.
Welcome to the Great British Menu Kitchen to all four of you.
Thank you very much.
Colin.
Hello, how are you?
How does it feel to be here?
Yeah, feeling a bit sick, but feeling good.
A little bit sick.
Yeah.
It'll pass and it will turn into the fuel that drives you through this competition.
Exactly.
Melissa, you got plenty of fuel in your tank?
I'm buzzing. Can't wait.
Niall.
Nervous?
Yeah.
Sated.
Sizing up the competition?
Sizing it up, yep.
So, four fantastic chefs. We start with the canapé.
Thank you.
All right, guys.
Cheers.
The canapés will be ranked and used to decide a tie break, should one arise at the end of the day.
Okay, bag's hot.
Melissa is making a langoustine and black pudding magnum.
It's a dish I do in my food truck, so I decided to do a small bite-sized version.
You want that out?
You take it out for me, please?
Yeah, no problem.
Thank you, chef.
Colin is making a vol-au-vent filled with fish, chips and peas, but his pastry is not all he hoped for.
I'm not happy with the previous ones, so I'm just going to revisit them and try and fix my mistake. There's nothing else for it, is there?
Niall is making a ceviche of pollen with a sourdough crustard, a fried batter casing.
Yep, not looking good.
But he's forgotten to bring a key piece of equipment.
I'm really, really annoyed. I left my crustard iron at home, which isn't the best place for it, but mistakes happen and try and rectify it. You all good?
I think so.
Lottie's canapes, duck liver and bergamot in foie de brick pastry, but she has got a problem too.
I filled these way too early and the pastry has gone soggy, so I have quickly made some more.
Oh, hello, Chef.
Hi, Andy.
I want to talk to you about veterans. Nope. So if I said Tommy Banks or Spencer Metzger or Michael O'Hare or Richard Corrigan...
No.
Tommy Banks would scare me.
Tommy Banks would scare
me. Just intimidates me a little bit.
Richard, I quite like. You know, very old school, but I think he likes tasty food.
He does. Who would you love to come through the door?
Also Tommy Banks.
Also Tommy Banks. Who would you be most alarmed by, do you think?
I think Richard Corrigan. He takes no prisoners.
In particular, Richard, but anybody comes through that door,
it's fine.
Just fine.
It could be any of those four veterans or somebody else that I've got hiding up my sleeve. All right, see you
soon.
Thank you very much.
Melissa gets her magnums into deep fry. Colin's new vol-au-vent pastry is on point.
Yeah, they're looking much better.
But it's a different story for Niall.
How are you looking?
Terrible. I'm struggling with my custard at the minute. I'm not going to be ready.
How long?
Well, I'll probably push it there about 5 minutes, if that's possible.
To make things worse, the veteran is approaching. Niall, just to be very clear, my love, after that extra five is up...
Yep.
..we will have to go.
Yep.
Our chefs from Northern Ireland will be judged by our longest-serving veteran, who cooked at the first two banquets. He's a stalwart of the Great British Menu Kitchen.
Sorry about this.
No, you're grand. You're all right.
It's Richard Corrigan. Chef.
How you doing?
Richard.
Hi.
How are you?
Richard.
Chefs, right.
That is a porter pogie langoustine and black pudding magnum.
What have we here?
So I'll try to intertwine a French classic and a British classic. So it's a vol-au-vent stuffed with the fish and chips.
I went with a custard, with a pollen ceviche, and a avocado sorbet.
And?
We have a duck liver mousse with bergamot.
Thank you very much, guys.
So, what would you be expecting from them, Richard?
I like chefs not to be too clever, but clever enough to fit the brief. And serve me some delicious food so I can give out some of those 10 points that you guys badly need.
Thank you very much.
Best of luck.
Thank you so much.
Having Richard Corrigan being the veteran judge does bring a bit of extra nerves.
He's firm but stern.
I absolutely love his food, so yeah, really excited.
Richard knows his grub, so I'm hoping to impress him.
Let's rank the dishes in order of preference.
Yeah, I think the ceviche just didn't do it for me at all.
That was Niall's dish.
Not enough seasoning. Right. And it just fell really flat on the palate.
Mm. Really fresh.
Lovely, man.
Wow.
Next dish was, Melissa, you know, the filling was really delicious, but it was just too much.
Lovely. Sauce bit on the top of it as well.
Yeah, good.
Who comes second for you,
I think the little cornetto.
Lottie.
It was slightly soggy, which is a great shame.
I think that was soggy because she was waiting for Niall some time. So we've already started with a little bit of chaos.
Yeah.
Oh, it's really nice.
Gorgeous.
So, number one.
Colin's fish and chip. It was delicious. It was the best thing on the pasta day.
Mmm.
Very good.
Also amazing. So comforting.
Look forward to the next courses.
Really?
Now for the first scored course, the starter, which must be a vegan dish.
For a starter, I like something light, elegant, delicious that sits in with the rest of the menu they're cooking for me.
Colin's starter is inspired by a canoeist who won silver at the Tokyo Olympics in 2020.
So the name is Silver Slalom, and my inspiration is Mallory Franklin.
So tell me, what are you cooking? What is the dish?
The dish is sleriak baked in ash and a salt crust, a dashi of mushroom broth with it, with spelt at the bottom of the sleriak, some sleriak puree with some local dulse. On the movement of water when they slalom, the broth will be poured in a nice way.
There isn't a lot here.
No, but yeah, hopefully I can get enough flavour into it.
Sleriak just beautifully cooked with a little bite in it is delicious.
Yes.
But overcooked, it's a bit of a disaster.
It's no good.
I wish you all the best.
Thank you very much, Richard.
I'm quite because you've got a whole bunch of stuff happening over here.
The inspiration is the opening ceremony of the Olympics. So the dish is called Goodwill, and that is goodwill between athletes and nations.
All right, so what's going to be on the plate, darling?
The flavours I want to get through is sleriak and apple. So I'm going to hay-bake sleriak. I'm making a sleriak champ. I'm going to cook it in unfiltered apple juice. I'm going to crisp up some of this as well. It's like crispy onions, but it's sleriak. And I'm going to make a sleriak stew.
There's a lot going on. There seems to be four dishes here. If you pull this off, it's going to be delicious.
Colin, same ingredients used quite differently.
Fair play. I'm worried, to say the least.
Niall's basing his dish on a sporting hero from Northern Ireland.
So my dish is Mary Peter's shot put. She won gold in the Olympics in Germany in 1972. Now, it was for the pentathlon, but it was the shot put that basically set her off to go on and win her gold.
How does a courgette get into the Olympics?
Well, my courgette's going to potentially look like a shot put. Going to go and try and hollow it out a wee bit. Instead, we're going to have a pickled yellow courgette, barbecue green courgette, and then it's going to be finished off with a yeast sauce. I'm going to have a Bloody Mary gel in there as well.
Well, now you're talking.
Very light-looking station you've got over here.
Yes.
What are you going to cook?
The title is the olive branch, and the inspiration is the wreath that the winners wore in the ancient Olympics. I'm making my own vegan cheese out of tofu, miso, and a bit of Chardonnay vinegar. I'm going to compress some cucumbers, and then I'm doing a sophistication olive in the middle of the plate.
Complex, a lot going on, a lot of building blocks in that dish.
Yep.
Best of luck.
Thank you so much.
For his canoeing-inspired dish, Colin is coating sleriak in burnt hay.
Hopefully they'll look like big black rocks.
Then encases them in salt dough.
Lovely.
Next, he turns to his mushroom dashi.
Just not enough flavour, so I'm just adding a wee bit more puccini mushrooms.
Having worked under some of the top chefs in the UK, Colin recently moved back home to Northern Ireland and has been working at Hugo in Belfast.
I got into cooking because my mother couldn't cook. I actually at the start wanted to be a graphic designer because I was very good at art. And then I realised that I could get my creativity on a plate, and I actually enjoyed the buzz and the adrenaline of a kitchen. My food philosophy now is zero wastage, try and champion the produce and not complicating it too much. I don't always like following the rules, but that, I think that in anything makes everything a little bit more exciting. Service, please.
Colin is using the ancient grain spelt in his starter to add texture.
How you doing?
Yeah, I think I'm on top of it. My spelt's just come out of mostly water, a bit of dulse, local dulse and stuff to try and get the flavour into it.
I wish you the best.
Thank you very much. Thank you, chef.
I mean, honestly, on my palate, it just felt completely flat. It was like eating a mouthful of birdseed.
Melissa is using similar ingredients to Colin.
I am getting my sleriak pan-fried, and then I'm going to cover them in hay and get them in the oven, because they take the longest to cook.
Melissa is making a sleriak champ. Like a mash, caramelising with onions, garlic and apple juice, she's still getting to grips with induction cooking.
I shouldn't be able to do that. It's meant to be the hardest part, too.
She starts her sleriak jus.
This one's definitely hotter than the other one.
And fries sleriak.
How you doing?
Well, the champ is caramelised and it's cooked the way I want it. I'm going to coarsely blend it now, and some crispy sleriak is going to go on.
Yeah,
top.
May I?
Yeah, please, of course. The crispy onions, only it's just sleriak. Yeah, nice texture.
If you say so.
Yeah. Oh.
Thank you. Melissa right now, there's a lot going on. You know, she puts too much of this on the plate. You're absolutely stuffed. You would never get to a fish course. You would never get to a main course. You are done.
Niall, how long do you want your yeast in?
Until it starts going brown.
While his yeast warms, Niall pickles courgettes.
Are you all right? I'll come back then.
and makes the marinade for his barbecue courgettes.
Ginger, bit of garlic, bit of olive oil, salt, pepper, very simple.
He sweats shallots and garlic before combining the yeast.
How's it all going?
So far, so good.
This is the
yeast sauce. Packs a punch.
Do you think so?
Niles yeast sauce. Yeah, it tasted good. But, you know, courgettes and this Bloody Mary gel. I just can't picture it in my head.
How are you?
Think I'm all right.
Lottie is working on a vegan cheese.
There's tofu and miso, and then I'm just going to add a bit of dill.
She compresses cucumbers in Chardonnay vinegar.
I knew that was something wrong with that tomato mix. That's not right. Use a butter.
She starts again.
Please work, please work, please work. One of us will be going home after the fish course.
Yeah.
Are we all feeling good?
I'm up first, so hopefully I'm on time.
I'm feeling all right, so Melissa, how are you feeling?
Nervous, but your nerves are good. They keep you in line, don't they?
You work out how to use induction yet, yeah?
Yeah. Oh, thanks, Chef.
Yeah. Well done, you.
Yeah.
You're just a...
What? It's a bit of fun. I'm trying to cheese up.
Me Captain Last Word over there, you know?
The last word.
is all your kitchen so serious and all? There's a bit of...
OK, next job.
Hi, Lottie.
Hello.
There's not much to taste here at the moment.
Well, you could taste leek and miso emulsion. You like it? You're not going to give me anything, are you?
Is there going to be enough to eat?
Yeah.
Calorie count very low on this one.
Yes.
Traditionally trained Lottie is head chef at Edo in Belfast.
At Edo, we serve European fine tapas. Being a chef for me isn't just about cooking. It's really helped me over the past 16 years. The discipline and the creative side of it has been amazing. It's extremely important to me to put all my love into everything I cook. That's my personality on a plate. Best part of being a chef is meeting so many amazing people in my career of all different walks of life, and it really has made me the person I am today. Getting to the banquet would mean everything to me. I worked very, very hard to get where I am.
Colin's serving first, and it's the moment of truth for his salt-baked celeriac.
Hopefully it'll be nicely cooked. Yeah, I think it's pretty good. So that's my spelt. It's going in the base, the diced chestnut mushrooms.
Celeriac is next, along with celeriac puree.
You need me to do anything?
Could you pour the dicey into the jug for me, even, lad, please?
Yep.
Followed by candied walnuts.
That looks unreal.
It looks class, doesn't it?
Oh, my days.
Looks brilliant.
Colin, you have 3 minutes.
I'm ready, chef. Will you take one? You might take one for me.
Gorgeous.
This is Silver Slalom by Mallory Franklin, and it's based on the movement of water when they're doing the slaloms.
Come on, tasting room.
Stunning.
Thank you, chef.
First one.
Why the spelt?
I like spelt, you know, but I could have used barley, it would have been a safer option, you know, but I like the texture, it gives it a bit more hearty as well.
What do you think about the cooking on the celeriac? You're making celeriac.
I think it's a wee bit too soft, but yeah, it's a nice texture.
Do you think the celeriac is under or overcooked?
It's a wee bit under, chef. Or a wee bit over, sorry. Excuse me.
I would have liked a little bit more seasoning to it.
Yeah, I agree. Flavours and textures are lovely, but it definitely needs more seasoning.
And tell me, the cream in there?
I made a celeriac puree with some dulse in it and blended it.
Do you want to taste that and tell me, do you think there's appropriate seasoning in there?
I didn't want to season it too much because the dashi is quite salty, so it's got dulse in there and stuff, so I wanted to keep it quite neutral, but I think it's spot on.
I have to agree with these two. Visually, it's lovely, but definitely missing the seasoning.
What would you score out of 10?
I think it's a solid 7. I might have cooked the celeriac a bit less, so that's why I would mark myself down.
I'm going to give it 7. It needs more seasoning.
6, because it's just missing that energy. Technically, very good.
If it had had that punch, for me, it would have been an 8, but I'm going to have to give it a 6.
Thank you very much, chefs. Up next, Melissa coats her hay-baked celeriac in apple treacle before reheating and then slicing the truffle.
Can I try the truffle?
No.
All right. Can I do anything at all for you, Pet?
Not right now.
Sweet. Yeah. Well, if you need me to taste anything, I'm ready.
Oh, I know, Pet.
She plates celeriac champ, topped with crispy fried celeriac.
Melissa, 1 minute.
Wait.
The pickled apple salad is topped with hazelnuts and truffle.
Get my celeriac out of the oven.
Shall we get that one out for you?
Yeah, thank you, Chef.
Melissa, you're due now.
Yep, sorry, Chef, 1 minute.
Celeriac jus and the hay-baked celeriac completes the dish. Just a minute behind the clock.
That's class.
So this is the light in the cauldron to start the Olympic Games. Goodwill between athletes and nations.
Nice.
Ooh, just like that.
Very good. It's still warm. Can we run to the tasting room when we get it done?
Please, you take the sauce. Thank you, Chef. Right, guys.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Good luck, Melissa.
Thank you, Andy.
She's a good cook.
Yeah.
She's a really good cook.
So, Melissa. Happy?
I think the texture of the celeriac is lovely, so I'm very happy with it.
What would you think about that champ, Niall?
Really, really good. I think everything worked, even the crispy celeriac on top of it and all.
The crispy celeriac is good, isn't it?
And are you happy with the champ?
I am, yeah. It's flavoursome, it has a great body, it does its job.
I think it comes together beautifully, but a little bit more truffle, a little bit more depth, but overall, absolutely gorgeous.
Do you think it's a large plate?
It's maybe borderline a wee bit too big, but it's very light when you eat it. It looks like a lot, but it has a very light touch.
All right, let's have some scores then.
Solid 8.
Lottie.
I'm going to go 9. She's got the balance perfect.
Yeah, a solid 9.
What would you score it?
I'd say 8. There's always room for improvement in everything that you do, and it needs more crispy bits. Hi.
Well?
How'd it go?
He's telling me.
Amazing.
No, I thought really, really good.
Like, unreal. Honestly,
really,
unreal.
Really, really good, yeah.
Absolutely gorgeous.
Bye-bye. Niall's hollowing out courgette and spraying to resemble a shot put, while his marinated courgettes are barbecued and also blow-torched for extra char.
5 minutes to the pass.
Pickled courgettes go into the shot puts first, followed by the barbecued courgette.
Very colourful.
Yeah, isn't
very
it?
Very striking.
Yeah.
And Bloody Mary gel.
These are on the vegetable, ladies. I'm on the Bloody Mary.
Finally, the yeast sauce and fried quinoa.
Very, very cool.
Title and inspiration.
Mary Peter's shot put. The shot put was one of her main events, and it sort of set her on her way to go and win gold.
Happy?
Yes.
Tasting room.
Very striking.
Nice one. Well done, lad.
Good luck, Chef.
Thank you.
It's slightly bananas.
Yeah.
I quite like that.
Textures are good. I like the flavours. Some of them stand out more than others.
I think it's a bit one-dimensional, to be fair, but, yeah, I think it's a bit too acidic. You know, you need something to sweeten it up in there.
The acid content in the dish, do you think it's too much?
I think it works. I think everything sort of works together.
Were you getting the barbecue flavour?
No.
Do you think the barbecue flavour has come true enough?
I think it can be improved. The barbecue, when I was using it, it wasn't strong enough, and then I used a blowtorch to try and get that wee bit of char to it.
And I think more seasoning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All
some bits were seasoned, but some bits weren't. I thought it was weird.
You happy?
I'm just wondering, should have went a wee bit more with the yeast sauce. I think it might have got a wee bit lost there.
Out of 10, what would you give yourself?
I would give myself a 7.
We're going to give it some scores. Let's start with you, Colin.
4. It's just one-dimensional, I think, that's it.
I'm going to give it a 6. It just needs a lot more love.
I'll give him a 6 because I know he's a very good chef, but I think he just got in his own head for this dish.
Oh, yeah, baby. Now we're talking.
Lottie is last to serve and is delighted with her new tweels. Vegan cheese is first to the plate.
Cheese looks like it has good texture.
I am actually really happy with the texture.
Compressed cucumber, followed by the leek and miso emulsion, and she's got a surprise.
I think I got stitched up here. Thanks for that, yeah. I think I look quite sexy, though.
For the dish's centrepiece, Lottie has made an olive mix for spherification.
So, wait, calcium reacts with
hasn't it?
Yes, so it forms this bubble around it.
She's got the skills, pay the bills.
Lottie, 2 minutes.
Yep.
I can't believe it's taken me so long to realise that Colin's in the toga. The olive spheres complete the dish.
The title of the dish is the olive branch, and the inspiration is the wreath that the winners wore in the ancient Olympic Games.
Tasting room.
Yep.
All right. She's done a lot of work here, hasn't she?
Yeah.
Shall we see if it's been worth it for her?
That is divine.
Solid, lovely, tasty.
Unbelievable. I'm not a tofu fan, but I am now.
Yeah.
So, Lottie, you happy with the vegan cheese?
Yep. I'm happy with the texture. It has that lovely nutty flavour from the miso.
And this is your olive.
The whole olive. You need to pop it in your mouth.
Happy with it?
I think so. I think I probably could have done with a little bit more salt.
The flavour on that olive was unreal.
For me, the only fault I would pinpoint would be a wee bit more flavour for the cucumber.
Did cucumber take enough seasoning on that?
I think that's the bit that I needed more salt.
Let's have some points, and I'm going to start with you.
Me, I would go a solid 9. Good 9. Really, really, really impressed with.
I would go 9 as well. Texture and a wee small bit of seasoning.
Yeah, I'd go an 8. I don't like the spherification covering, you know what I mean? I would have loved a lot more of that sauce to play with the cheese and the crackers or whatever.
Out of 10, what would you give it?
An 8, maybe.
Based on?
The spherification olive probably could have been slightly better. Maybe the texture was not quite there and a little bit more salt on the cucumbers. But apart from that, I'm happy.
Yes, Lottie.
Oh, there she is, the olive girl.
Where's
your... The olive girl.
All good?
I loved the whole thing.
No, it was great.
I did. Yeah. It was class. I just wanted a bigger portion than a glass of white wine.
What do you think about your dish, lad?
Well, we've got to shut up a wee bit more sauce on.
Absolutely.
Well, you live and learn.
Yeah.
That starter's done. We're through the first course. There's a nice energy in that kitchen.
A wonderful crew.
A wonderful crew. I feel like a couple of them need to settle.
There's a point or two separating the low from the high.
Right, so it's quite close. I wonder who's going to break away from the pack. Chefs, a great energy in this kitchen, I have to say. However, a little slow out of the starting blocks for some of you.
Colin, your dish, silver slalom. The presentation was great. I liked the way the dashi poured down the slope. But the dashi could have had a much bigger flavour. The spelt, I was really concerned of where you were going to use it. But it did work, and it was a really, really great surprise for me. The ash-baked celeriac was a little bit overcooked. And overall, the dish just lacked in a few areas. Melissa, for your dish, goodwill. The celeriac was cooked very well, and it was the right texture, just spot on. The celeriac jus was delicious as well. The portion size, though, was a little bit big. It was certainly more of a main than a starter. The crispy celeriac, you certainly could have done with a little more of that. Niall, for your dish, Mary Peters, shot put. I do like courgettes raw and semi-cooked. I was looking forward to a little bit more barbecue flavour coming through. The pickled courgette was very strong, and that really was a problem for me in the whole dish. The yeast sauce was a lovely idea when I tasted it on your section, but I didn't really feel it was on the dish in the tasting room. So a little bit more of that sauce would have been a really good idea. Lottie, for your dish, the olive branch. The cheese made out of tofu was well made and tasted good. The cucumber, it was really just cucumber. There was nothing interesting about it. The spherification of olive, it was okay. I think you should look at tapenades and other little southern European flavours. Unfortunately, I don't think the dish was a complete dish. It did feel like it was one large canapé.
And so to the scores.
Niall, I'm giving you a 5.
Everything that you put on the plate needs to be completely delicious, and I think you got a bit distracted there.
Lottie, I'm giving you a 6.
You had a good basic idea there, but in the end, it just felt complicated for the sake of being complicated. It didn't make anything better.
Colin, I'm giving you a 7.
It just all felt muted.
Yeah.
Somehow. More of you in there, Colin.
Melissa, I'm scoring you an 8.
Good cooking, particularly on that celeriac. Beautiful caramelization all the way around it. It's just very big, though, so do look at your portion sizes. All right, after the next course, one of your races will come to an end. So take a deep breath, shake it off, and really focus on this next course, the fish.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well done.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
I was expecting a 3, so...
Nice one, guys, let's do it.
So it's time for the fish course, Richard. What are your expectations from these chefs?
I want a beautiful piece of fish, cooked with elegance, dressed with passion, and delivered to me to enjoy.
It's nice getting a good score, but, you know, we still need to keep your head and your shoulders and try and do better for the second course.
I need to smash my fish course, but it needs to be on point and the flavours need to be there, or I could be going home.
Disappointed, but understand it. There's not many points in it. Fish should be my sort of thing.
Yeah, I'm a little bit gutted. I have a lot to prove heading into the fish.
I'm making my treacle and stout little soda breads. Very traditional bread in Ireland. My nana would have made these a lot. Looked awful, but it comes together.
The bread will accompany river trout, and she'll use the offcuts for a stock base for her veloute.
My main concern of this dish is getting that sauce perfect, getting the fish barbecued perfectly, and my bread being cooked in time.
Melissa's trout will be served in two ways, barbecued and cured.
The title of the dish is I Needed That, and the inspiration behind the dish is angling. The first time angling was in the Olympics was in 1900 in River Seine. Wow. That's why I chose river trout. So I just brushed it lightly with a bit of poaching. So it's kind of like a gravlax, but a wee bit of poaching instead.
So that's like a really seriously strong alcohol, right?
Yeah, so, you know, delicate touch again, and it's gone on my wee soda bread, so apple treacle and stout bread.
And cooking the trout, what kind of temperature are you looking for?
Pink in the middle. I'm gonna...
Quite difficult.
Yes, I'm used to my own barbecues, and you don't get to do it twice. It's a bit of crack, but it's delicious, you know.
Sounds a little gorgeous. Bit of crack, yeah. I love it.
Lottie is making a mojo rojo, a spicy sauce from the Canary Islands.
Charred red peppers, shallot, chili flakes, cumin. I have hot paprika, smoked paprika. After the starter, I'm just a little bit depleted, so I just need to kind of forget about that and just crack on.
Lottie needs to channel the spirit of her inspiration, Baron Pierre de Coubertin. He was the founder of the modern Olympics in 1894 and proposed the Olympic motto, faster, higher, stronger.
His last wish before he died was for his heart to be buried in Olympia.
Oh,
I know that's a little bit sad, but
no, it's
quite
beautiful.
An interesting. He had so much passion for what he does. I'm basing my dish around that. So I have a lemongrass sauce with confit monkfish, and then I'm going to sear it on the barbecue, and then a mojo, like a spiced tomato and red pepper sauce.
Mojo rojo.
Mojo rojo. I'm going to set it in love heart moulds and hopefully pop them out on the plate, and then love heart tweels. So I'm basing it around love hearts.
And
yeah.
Love. And passion. Lovely. Yeah.
What do you think, Chef?
Yeah, I mean, lots of good flavours there. A brave dish as well, pushing the boundaries again.
Yeah.
Colin's filleting his sea bass.
I'm going to get the bones onto the barbecue because I'm going to make a dashi flour gel.
He reserves the fish skin for later.
When I'm serving, I'll deep fry it. It's going to be one of the textures of my dish. If I can nail this the way I want it to, I think I have a chance of getting through to the mark. The title of my dish is Delivering Gold, and the inspiration is Bethany Firth. She's a gold medalist, Paralympian swimmer.
Brilliant.
She lives very close to me. As I was going to Belfast every day to work, I remember driving past a golden post box.
Her golden egg.
And it was there because of her, because of all her success.
Brilliant.
I'm not actually cooking my fish, Richard. It's more of a ceviche. My sea bass, it's in the fridge. I'm going to slice it nice and thin. A wee bit of the milder rapeseed oil with some lemon juice. And then I'm making a dashi-styled fish sauce, which is here. I'm going to turn that into a gel. And it's going to have some crispy skin.
Is there a reason you didn't do a hot fish dish?
It might be a bit simpler than cooking a piece of fish and stuff, but I hope this time I can deliver to Richard some flavour and he'll score me high without cooking the fish.
Colin, always pushing those boundaries. Hopefully he's not downhill.
100%, right. Thank you.
Good luck.
Cheers.
At the bottom of the pack, it's fish specialist Niall.
Hopefully I'll do a bit better in this course and pull myself back into it.
He's braising shin of beef to accompany his fish.
It's in the pressure cooker, so hopefully that I'll be on time and have it ready.
Niall's using the same inspiration as Lottie for his dish, Ode to the Baron. Please tell us about your dish, darling. What is the inspiration behind it?
It's Pierre de Coubertin.
Oh, right, so we're talking about the father of the
founder
Olympics.
Founder of the Olympics.
Got you.
And also that because it's in France, and I also worked in a French restaurant for 3 years in Belfast.
Right.
So I'm trying to put my sort of French Northern Irish twist to it.
Okay.
So we're going to do a pomme puree, and then it's going to be braised beef shin with a brioche crumb and a nice roast fillet of hake on top.
So surf and turf.
Surf and turf.
Hake is a delicate fish,
it
yeah?
It is, yep.
And are you confident that shin is going to work with it?
Yeah, well, throughout the years of me working, it's something that I've always had on.
Brilliant.
Melissa portions her trout that's been cured in salt, sugar, chives and tarragon.
So I'm starting to build my trout roses now. You don't want to be doing this to order because it's a wee bit fiddly.
Melissa went travelling to Australia 13 years ago and while she was there, had a eureka moment.
That's when I first stepped into a real kitchen. That was in Melbourne, it was a German restaurant. The food was amazing, and that's when my eyes opened and I was like, wow, this is what I want to do. Came back to Ireland, and then I was like, right, this is where I want to be now, this is where I want to cook. Going for the food truck. Tell you the truth, I didn't think about it very much. I actually just went and did it. Before I realised what I'd done, I was driving up from Donegal and a food trailer attached. The same ethos I have in the truck will be the same ethos I have in the restaurant. One day, when I get it. Seasonal food, sourced locally, and everything's cooked fresh.
Back in the kitchen, Melissa's keeping a close eye on her velouté and finishing the baked soda breads.
I'm just giving it a last little glaze with the apple treacle.
So, Melissa.
Hi, Chef.
A little scone out of the oven, yeah?
Yes. Would you like to try one?
Yeah, I'd love one. Go on.
Please.
Soft?
Yep.
I smell the stout in there.
Yeah, it's nice, and that beautiful apple treacle as well. So that's just going to be piped with a little bit of creme fraiche and some cured trout on top.
You're happy with everything, where everything's going?
I am, yes, but now I've seen the clock. I'm running out of time now,
yeah,
so I'm going to have to start moving.
Okay,
thank you.
It's a small scone, I'll be honest with you. I prefer things made in a loaf and sliced so you taste the whole thing. Jury's out.
Lottie is whipping up a lemongrass sauce, adding cream to lemongrass, ginger, shallots and fish stock, as well as making heart-shaped tweels.
What are you doing in my blast chiller?
Oh, little hearts. You shouldn't have.
And her mojo rojo spicy sauce has been blended.
Lottie.
Hello.
Good, good, good. You look all prep. Your hearts look like they're on their way.
Yeah.
This sauce, yeah?
Yeah, check it out.
Ooh, packs a punch.
Yes, nice kick.
Full of spice, full of flavour. As a matter of fact, quite delicious. Hopefully, Lottie is going to give us a dish that says, wow, that deserves to go to Paris.
Her monkfish goes into a bath of olive oil to confit.
Is it 60, yeah?
Yes,
sir. Right?
Meanwhile, Colin is frying a capers and shallots garnish.
Basically, some shallot onion rings.
Delicately slices the bass for his ceviche, keeping an eye on his crispy fish skin.
They're flying without wings.
And his fish stock is ready.
So, Colin, everything done?
Nearly, yeah, you're getting there.
What am I tasting?
So the stock that will be turned into a gel eventually, so that's got the bones in it and then all the fish trim so I didn't waste anything.
Lovely. I wish you the very best.
Thank you so much, Chef.
I'm still slightly concerned on
certain
things.
Yeah, absolutely, I get that.
Now, I really, really, really hope for Colin that he really has thought this through. I do expect a fish course to be unctuous, warm, delicious, and can we have more, please?
Chasing the pack, Niall is braising red onions in stock and red wine for a jus. Niall is head chef at the Rabbit Hotel near Antrim and has worked in Michelin-starred restaurants, including Cayenne in Belfast.
My father used to own a kebab shop, watching him come home and cooking in the house. You know, it was something that always interested me. And from a very young age, I've always loved cooking, you know. I love seafood. I think coming from father living over in Egypt, the fish over there, it's unreal, you know. But then also Northern Ireland, the amount of fish that you can get here, so much variety. Being on the Great British Menu is probably the most important thing that I've ever done in my life. When I told my father, he couldn't have been any more over the moon than what I was.
Niall's filleting hake and is keeping his fingers crossed for his beef shin.
Never used one of these before, so I'm panicking about that.
He's mixing a Northern Irish hard cheese with cream for his pom puree.
Once the potatoes are braced, then I'll add both of them in it.
Come here, what do we hear?
So this is the pom puree with the terrican cheese in it.
Any worries?
Just that the shin's going to be cooked.
OK, good. Great. Enjoy.
Yes, thank you.
Niall's potato with the cheese is tasty. I mean, I get the feeling of some nice bar food is going through my head, you know what I mean? Hopefully he puts something up with elegance, deliciousness. You know, an Olympic feast really needs a great dish.
Leader Melissa is up first. She chars her trout and passes her velouté.
Right, stop breathing there.
Creme fraiche holds her trout roses in place atop the soda bread.
3 minutes, Melissa.
Woohoo!
You want me to mind your face or anything?
No, should be grand. Yeah. It's gonna be late now if I keep moving.
She garnishes with sea lettuce.
How you getting on, Melissa? Grand, my fish is nearly there. I had to be alum and out, so I didn't want to overcook it.
But time is not on her side.
Melissa, you're on the pass.
Sorry.
Right. Sorry, coming now.
The trout sits on samphire.
Sauce? A wee bit froth here?
Yeah.
Please.
Are you putting it straight on your fish or have you got jug?
I'll get a jug. Good shout.
The sauce is decanted and split with leek oil.
You're 3 minutes over here. Got there in the end.
Sorry, Anne. The dish title is called I Needed That, and the inspiration is the first and last time England was in the Olympics in 1900.
Well, you've taken quite a while to plate that. Let's go and taste this in the tasting room.
Yes, I'm going to get slaughtered.
Yeah. The fish, happy with the cooking?
Slightly a bit over now. But it's still nice, still moist. The skin isn't too bitter. It's just a nice charcoal flavour.
Skin's too bitter for me.
I think the fish is overcooked. I would cook the trout a little bit less.
It's a bit dry at the edges and stuff, isn't it?
And are you happy with the sauce?
I'm happy with the sauce. The hint of smoke in it. There's a nice bit of acidity.
What do you think about that velouté?
Subtle, but nice.
The balance, again, she's got perfect.
And are you happy with the texture of the bread?
I am, yeah. It's light, it's crunchy on the outside, and it's soft. And I think delicious on the inside.
I like that bread.
Yeah, the bread's good.
Very, very nominal.
Yeah, yeah. Niall, you a fan? Yeah, definitely. It was very, very good.
How would you score this dish?
For this dish, I give myself a 7 because my fish is overcooked a little bit.
I'm going to go 8. Room for improvement, but only a few tweaks.
I'm going to go an 8 as well.
Just after the first dish, I expected so much, but it is still a great dish, so I'm just going to give it a 7.
Hi,
well,
guys.
How'd that go?
Oh. Wasn't happy with myself.
It was great.
Yeah, it wasn't what I wanted.
Lottie's up next. While her monkfish is finishing on the barbecue, she plates her moho rojo hearts.
Can we get your fish off, Chef?
Yes, please.
Can I help?
No.
Thank you.
You can share that, Dad.
I always get shared that. Is this like girl bar where the boys don't get them join in or what?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
That's beautiful.
3 minutes to the pass.
Yep.
Happy with the cuisson?
It's nice, it's juicy, it's cooked.
Looks good.
Yep, thank you.
2 minutes left.
Yep.
Lime gel and micro coriander are added.
Hot food is good, guys.
Yep, sorry.
And the heart-shaped tweels finish the dish.
So the title is Father of the Modern Olympics. His last wish was for his heart to be buried in Olympia.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Good luck, Chef. Right, barbecued monkfish. Let's be having you.
So, happy, Lottie?
No. I should have let the monkfish rest a little bit because it's got a bit of liquid at the bottom of their plate.
I really, really like the flavours. The heat in this is unreal.
Mojaroho.
Yeah. It's beautiful. And the sauce itself is beautiful as well.
And the lemongrass sauce, happy with that?
Yeah, I am. I think it goes really nice with the mojaroho.
It is amazing what a bit of salt can do to something.
Mm-hmm.
Nice texture of monkfish as well.
Yeah, the monkfish is definitely well cooked. I think it's on point, will it?
The fish is cooked nice, but yeah, it just could do with being a bit hotter.
She's a very smart cook.
Yeah, she is, and very ambitious in what she's reaching for.
Yeah.
Niall, do you think she's reached it?
I like the dish. She was right up my street.
Anything you change?
Just the resting, and I would definitely have it a bit sooner on the barbecue just to get the heat through it a bit better.
Out of 10, what would you give it?
I would probably give it an 8.
I think it's an 8. If she could have got the fish out and rested it, it would have been a 9 even.
I think I'm going to go an 8 as well. For me, the fish was cooked. Yes, it could have been rested, but solid 8 for me, yeah.
I'm going to agree with the boys and go 8 as well. Flavour profile's unreal.
Rubbish.
Delicious.
It was cold.
No.
Lolly.
And it didn't rest. He hated it. I can feel it.
No,
don't say that. You don't know that. Flavours were class. Class.
Up next, and with no fish to cook, Colin adds the dressing to his ceviche.
Bit of lemon juice, lemon zest, Maldon salt, and this lovely rapeseed. Beautiful.
The dashi stock gel is combined with trout roe, preserved lemon and dill.
Classic ceviche.
Really classic. Just letting the fish do the talking.
It's just as much work going into the cold dish.
But I suppose you don't have to rest it and stuff. You know?
Thanks for that.
I'll be laughing on the other side of my face, will you see?
Nasturtium flowers are followed by the crispy fish skin.
Golden letterbox.
3 minutes.
Yep, thank you. Could somebody drop the onion rings to crispen them up and bring them over to me, please?
Trout roe and the crispy shallot rings complete the dish.
No shaky hands anywhere.
Oh, no. Shaking Stevens.
You're like a naughty little school class, you four. Don't know why, there's something about them.
To the tasting room before we cook it and that soy casserole. Yeah.
Matches up in there.
Thank you.
I can't ask you how you're happy with the cooking of it.
Yeah.
Visually? Yeah, really, really good, and didn't disappoint. The crispy skin was really, really good, worked out really well.
Happy with the crispy fish skin?
Yeah, I think it puffed up well. It's got the air bubbles that you want.
Naughty. Is it enough? Is it a whole dish?
I wouldn't say it's a whole dish. I would say it's more like a starter.
Does it bring happiness?
Brings, yeah. Obviously not in the cooking of the fish.
Do you think this passes for a fish course?
Yes, I think so. It's bass. I think it's great cooked as well, but it's nice sometimes to go the other way and let the fish itself do the talking.
I think it is missing some sort of carb. It would be a lovely starter.
Out of 10?
I think it's an 8.
9. Very, very good.
I'm going to go 8 just because I think he's played it a little bit safe.
8, just think it's missing something.
Where are you dropping the points?
Just didn't look as pretty as I wanted it to. Flowers should have been golden, and, you know, I was delivering gold and it didn't quite deliver gold.
Looks a bit bronze.
Plating last and currently in last place, Niall's frying his hake.
This feels very...
It doesn't feel like it's hot enough.
The hottest part of it is here. Do you want another pan on?
Yes, stick me another one on.
The man with a pan.
Man with a pan.
The hake is transferred to a hotter pan, and the pomme puree is plated.
No, 3 minutes to the pass.
Yeah.
Why did Colin answer?
I don't know.
Yeah, but I'll be up in 3 minutes.
Braised onion, brioche crumb, and the French onion jus.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God.
Three perverts.
The hake is added.
What about this? Are you using this?
But he's forgotten his braised beef shin.
He forgot his shin.
Save me, Erlich.
No swelling.
At last, someone brought me dinner.
Yeah.
Oh, you look, you got a big bowl of mash.
Yeah, you're looking, are you? Dinner, yeah? Feed me. Yeah?
It's based on Pierre de Coubertin.
Good. At least I'm going to eat tonight.
Yeah.
I'm quite intrigued by this dish. I've never had hake and beef, so let's see how it works out.
Happy with the mash?
Yep.
Do you think the flavour of the cheese has came true?
Yep, I definitely do, 100%.
The mashed potato has got that Irish cheese, hard cheese running through it.
And it's great. It's nice, creamy.
What about the cuisson of the fish?
What I like to have a crispier skin on it.
Fish could do a better sear in the pan, I think.
Yes.
What about the beef shin?
Yeah, the beef shin could have been a wee bit more sticky, but I think with the dew that I put on, that saves it.
The hake and the beef together, Melissa.
They're both quite strong flavours. Maybe they're fighting a little bit.
Out of 10, what would you give it?
An 8.
I would go 6. It's not enough texture, but it'd be nice maybe with the fish skin, crisped as well.
Yeah, I'd give it a 7. Bit of solid cooking, bit more sauce, a little bit less sweet, but 7.
I'm going to go 7. A little bit more love on the fish, a little bit more texture.
Could there be improvements? 100%. There always can be in everything, but I fancy my chances. How's it going, guys?
Oh, good. That was lovely.
Yeah, it was solid.
Yeah, the potato was unreal with the shin.
You know yourselves. Once you taste your own dishes, you'll start going, I could have done this, should have done this, should have done that.
Can't take it back.
Nope.
No.
Lukewarm, cold, no seasoning, raw. I just think, you know, where's the love?
So, guys, how are you feeling about someone leaving?
Nervous, and I think any one of us could go.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's safe.
We've got 5, 6, 7, 8 here. In terms of scoring, so the pack is tight.
You never have to approach as a judge. It's always the contestant that sends themselves home.
Right. Interesting. Melissa is on 8 points, Colin 7, Lottie 6, and Niall is on 5. Chefs, you've all worked really hard today. I do have a feeling that you haven't quite settled into this kitchen yet. It really does get the better of even the most talented chefs.
Let's start with you, Melissa. For your dish, I needed that. The presentation looked nice, and I thought it hit the brief. I loved the texture of the skin. However, the fish was overcooked, which was a great shame. The velouti, a little bit flat. I wanted a lot more leek oil in there, as it felt very creamy. The apple treacle stout bread was indeed very tasty. The cure on the trout didn't blow me away. It could have certainly done with a little bit more cure. There was 2 separate dishes here. I'm not sure they both work together. You promised a lot, and I'm a little bit disappointed with the execution. Lottie, for your dish, father of the modern Olympics, it was a lovely place of food, and you got the story coming true. The monkfish was cooked well, but you need to serve it hot. You thought it wasn't rested enough. I thought it was so well rested, it became cold. The mojo rojo was punchy, and I really loved it. You could have put a little bit more on the monkfish, give it a little bit more oomph. This is potentially a very elegant plate of food, but it was spoiled by lukewarm fish and a cold place. Colin, for your dish, delivering gold, the presentation with the golden letterbox was fun. The sea bass was dressed nicely. There was a great burst of flavour from the salmon roe. The crispy skin did add some flavour, but my little bit was soggy from sitting on the sauce. What I'm struggling with was this dish, an assembly dish of great ingredients put into a bowl. And with your background, I would have expected a little bit more oomph and skill. It was brave to go with the ceviche with Asian flavours, and it shows great confidence. But for me, the Great British Menu, we need dishes that stand out, stand tall, find our place on the podium. Niall, for your dish, Ode to the Baron, there was really very little connection to the brief. I think that giving me a French dish just wasn't really good enough. The hake was a little bit overcooked. The skin could have done with a little bit more colour, but the fish was well seasoned and warm. I think you really didn't need the beef shin on the plate. It is an elegant fish course we're looking for.
And so to the scores.
Melissa, I'm giving you a 6.
The char on that skin on my piece of trout. It was taken too far. It was really acrid.
Colin, I'm giving you a 6.
We need you to push yourselves, and I feel like you didn't really on this course.
Lottie, I'm scoring you 7.
Attention to detail makes all the difference.
Niall, I'm scoring you a 6 as well.
So with 11 points, Niall, I'm afraid you're going to be leaving the kitchen. You've been great to have you here.
Thank you.
Great.
Thank you for having me.
Well done. Well done, guys. I'm not going to be judging you for the rest of the competition. I'm sure you're happy to hear that. But it's out with the old, as they say, and in with the new. I'm leaving you in the capable hands of a really wonderful young cook.
Spencer.
Afternoon.
Hello, Chef.
Hey, Spence.
Hello.
How you doing, Chef?
Good to be back.
So we like to keep you on your toes around here.
Yeah, absolutely. I wish you all the best of luck. Main course is next, so precision in your cookery, big, bold flavours, don't leave anything behind. Go for it.
Thank you very much, chefs.
Have chefs.
Nice.
Good, Annie.
Well done, well done.
Yeah,
well
come
done.
On, here, bear hug. Just get him.
I don't know what to think about it, but I'll give it my best.
I really need up my game to make it to the judges' chamber.
Obviously, I'm not happy about my 6, and that's more fire to the belly tomorrow to do well in my main course.
I'm really excited about having a new veteran chef. Richard is amazing, but I think Spencer's more my style of cooking.
Main courses are up next. Spencer takes over as the judge. They are representing Northern Ireland. They really need to pull up their socks.
Tomorrow.
Deep breath.
Our three remaining chefs need to up their game if they're going to cook for the judges.
Do, 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 action.
And veteran chef Spencer shows why he's not one to settle for second place.
At the end of it, you can all lay on the floor and sleep, I don't care.
Yeah,
but just push and push and push.